Today we have problems on orthocenter. Okay, so what is orthocenter? Orthocenter is the point of intersection of altitudes of a triangle is orthocenter. The point of intersection of altitudes of a triangle is orthocenter. So orthocenter, suppose we draw a triangle. A, B, C are the three vertices of a triangle. Now, draw one perpendicular from vertex A to the base BC. Okay, now, this altitude is always perpendicular to the base or the other side. Okay, so what is AD called? It is the altitude of a triangle ABC. This altitude is respect to the base BC. Now, we can draw one more altitude from vertex B to AC. So this is one more altitude. So B is an altitude. Next, one more altitude we draw. C F is one more altitude. Now all these altitudes are intersecting at one point. So this point is known as orthocenter. So generally the orthocenter is denoted by letter O. So what is orthocenter? The point of intersection of altitudes of a triangle is orthocenter. So all the altitudes meet at one point. So this point is known as orthocenter. Right. Now while solving the problems on orthocenter, we come across a concept called slope. Now what is slope? Now when two points are given, x1, y1 and x2, y2. These are the two points. How to find the slope? The slope between two points or the slope of AD is, the ratio of the difference of y coordinates to x coordinates. The ratio of the difference of y coordinate to x coordinates. That means the slope of AD is nothing but y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So, while solving the problems on orthocenter, we come across the slope. Okay, so please note down, this also will be used in the problems. Now, we'll solve the problem on orthocenter. Okay, so now, orthocenter is nothing but the point of intersection of altitudes. So, while solving the problem on orthocenter, first we draw a triangle. This is the triangle. ABC. Represent the vertices as ABC. Now, what is orthocenter? The point of intersection of altitudes. So, we can get three altitudes from the triangle, but here, for solving this problem, we need only two altitudes. So, draw one perpendicular to this. AD is one altitude. And next, one more altitude we draw from BE. BE is the other altitude. Now, to find the orthocenter, we need to solve the equation of AD and equation of BD. So here, using the vertices, we'll find out the equation of altitude AD and equation of altitude B. Then we'll solve those two equations, we'll get orthocenter. Okay, we'll do one problem. So let A is equal to the first vertex -2, -1 and B is equal to, it is 6, -1. C is equal to 2, 1. Now these are the three vertices. So first what we do, we find out the equation of altitude AD. Okay, but here AD is perpendicular to BC. So in order to find AD, we'll start the problem with the base. So now, first what I do, I find out slope of BC. See, what is slope between two points? Slope between two points is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So I find out the slope of the base BC. That is nothing but B and C are to see x1 y1, x2 y2. So y2 minus y1 by, it is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, y2 minus of minus, okay, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So what we get is 5 plus 1 by 2 plus 6. Okay, I'll write directly. 5 plus 1 is 6, y minus 4. And if we cancel and we get the slope as minus 3 by 2. So what is slope of BC is got minus 3 by 2. Now we find out the slope of AD. See, how to get slope of AD? Slope of AD is nothing but, see, here AD is perpendicular to BC. AD is perpendicular to BC. Remember, whenever two lines are perpendicular, what you do is, already we got the slope of BC. To get the slope of AD, as AD is perpendicular, what you do is, reverse number, change sign. We got 2 by 3. See, we have minus 3 by 2. Reverse number, I get 2 by 3. Change the sign. What is the sign actually? We have minus. So you have to put plus. Okay. Suppose if you get plus 3 by 2, the slope will be minus 2 by 3. Okay. So reverse the number, change the sign. When you have to do this, this you have to do when two lines are perpendicular. First I got the slope of BC. Then reverse the number, change the sign, you get slope of AD. When you have to do reverse the number, change the sign only in case of perpendicular lines. Here AD is perpendicular to BC. So to find the slope of AD, as it is perpendicular to BC, reverse the number, change the sign, we get slope of AD. After getting slope of AD, I'll find out the equation of AD. To find the equation of AD, the formula is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. But remember this one. To find the equation of the line, it is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So here, what is m? M is nothing but the slope of AD. What is m? Slope of AD. Because as we are finding equation of AD, we will take slope of AD. What is slope of AD? 2 by 3. And here, x1, y1 is a point. Now from where we are getting the point? On AD, as we are finding equation of AD, we don't know what is D. So we have to take point A. So what is point A? Point A is nothing but minus 2 comma minus 1. Now I find out the equation. It is y minus y1. When I substitute, it will become plus 1 is equal to m value is 2 by 3. So write 2 by 3 into x minus x1 is minus 2. So write plus 2. Okay. Now I will simplify. Simplify means just cross multiply this thing. 3 into y plus 1 is equal to 2 into x plus 2. Now I will multiply this equation. So I get 3y plus 3 is equal to 2x plus 4. Multiply to 2. Now rewrite the equation. First to the x term, next y term, then numbers, constants. So to write that equation, what I do is, first 2x plus 4 as is. The remaining terms transpose to the other side. We get minus 3y minus 3 is equal to 0. Minus 3y minus 3 is equal to 0. So that is, we get 2x minus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0. So put it as equation 1. See, we got equation of AD. Now we find out equation of B. So when I am finding the next attribute, second attribute B, the base should be AC. So what you have to do? Again we find out slope of AC. So here I write slope of AC. So again, what it is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So A and C are meaning. So it is y2 minus y1. Y2 minus y1. Slope of AC by x2 minus x1. X2 minus x1. So what is slope of AC we get? It is nothing but 5 plus 1 is 6 by 4, it is 3 by 2. Okay, 6 by 4 is 3 by 2. After getting slope of AC, we have to find out the equation of slope of altitude is BE. As BE is perpendicular to AC, reverse the number, change sign, you will get slope of BE. So, what is slope of BE? Slope of BE is nothing but minus 2 by 3. Reverse the number, change sign. 3 by 2 is the slope of AC. As B is perpendicular to AC, reverse the number. 3 by 2 will become 2 by 3. Change sign. What is the sign for 3 by 2? Is plus. When we change, it will become minus 2 by 3. After getting slope of BE minus 2 by 3, we find out the equation of BE. So, what is the equation of BE? The same formula. Y minus Y1 is equal to M into X minus X1. Y minus Y1 is equal to M into X minus X1. So, when I am finding the equation of BE, I will take point B. What is point B we have? It is 6 comma minus 1. And what is the slope I have to take? Slope as BE. So, M is equal to minus 2 by 3. As I am finding the equation of BE, I need slope of BE and point B. Because we don't know what is point E. See, on BE, you know B. So, using that only, we have to find the equation. So, now, Y minus, Y1, minus into minus, plus, is equal to M value. What is M value? It is minus 2 by 3 into X minus X1. So, I am substituting. Y minus Y, minus into minus, plus, is equal to M value is minus 2 by 3 into X minus X1 is 6. Okay, so now we will simplify. Just cross multiply. Cross multiply means divide 3 into Y plus 1 is equal to minus 2 into X minus 6. Now I multiply this. So we get 3Y plus 3 is equal to minus 2X plus 12. Minus 2x plus 12. Now rewrite this equation. Rewrite this equation. Rewrite this equation means first minus 2x plus 12 as is. The remaining terms we transpose on the other side. When we transpose, sign changes. Minus 3 by minus 3. Minus 3 by minus 3 is equal to 0. So we get minus 2x. Minus 3y plus 9 is equal to 0 we want. Okay. Now, I will take minus sign common. This is not compulsory, but I will take minus sign common. The reason is, x coefficient is negative. So, I am taking minus sign common. So, what I get if I take minus sign common? 2x plus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0. See, when we take minus sign common, minus terms will become plus. Plus terms will become minus. Plus 2x minus 3 become plus 3y plus 9 will become minus 9 is equal to 0. And no need to show that the common minus sign as we are writing 0 in RHS. So put this as equation 2. Okay, now see we got equation of AD. This is equation of AD. Next we got equation of B. Equation of AD. Equation of B. So now what we will do is, we will solve the equations 1 and 2. Okay, so we will solve equations 1 and 2. What is equation 1? It is 2x minus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0. And this next equation is 2x plus 3y minus 9 is equal to 0. When we subtract, we change the sign. I am solving by the elimination method. Okay. So, plus 2x minus 2x, we cancel. Now, we have minus 3y minus 3y. This will become minus 6y plus 10 is equal to 0. So, we get minus 6y is equal to minus 10. Minus 6y is equal to minus 10. So, we can cancel minus minus. So, y value will be 10 by 6. Okay, y value is 10 by 6. So, what is 10 by 6? 2 5s are 10, 2 3s are 6. 2 5s are 10, 2 3s are 6. So, y value is 5 by 3. Now, after that, what we will do? We need to find the value of x. So, substitute the value of y in equation. See, you can use equation 1 or 2. Get the value of x. Anyone equation you can use. I am using equation 1. So, equation 1. So, what is equation 1? It is 2x minus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0 is equation 1. In this equation, I am substituting y value as 5 by 3. So, 2x minus 3 into 5 by 3 plus 1 is equal to 0. Instead of y, substitute 5 by 3. After substituting, you can cancel 3, 3. Okay. After cancellation, it is 2x minus 5 plus 1 is equal to 0. 2x minus 4 is equal to 0. 2x is equal to 4. So, x is equal to 4 by 2. X is equal to 4 by 2. What is 4 by 2? It is 2. So, we got the x value. So, therefore, what is ortho center we got? It is x comma y. It is 2 comma 5 by 3. So, what is the ortho center? It is x comma y. Of course, you should write x then y. It is 2 comma 5 by 3 is the ortho center. So, this problem is completed. So, next problem. Find the ortho center of a triangle whose vertices are 5 comma minus 2, minus 1 comma 2, 1 comma 4. Okay. So again, to solve this, what we do? Always we have to draw a triangle. The vertices is ABC. Okay. Now draw the attributes. That means AD is an attribute which is perpendicular to BC. BE is an attribute perpendicular to AC. Okay. Now, the given points will represent as A, B and C. So, the second problem. So, let A is equal to 5 comma minus 2. B is equal to minus 1 comma 2. C is equal to 1 comma 4. Okay. These are the three vertices. So, we need equation of attributes. Equation of attributes means first we need equation of AD. Okay. Then we find out equation of BE. To find equation of AD, as AD is perpendicular to BC, we start with the base BC. Okay. How to start with the base BC? First we find out slope of BC. Slope of BC. So how do you find slope of BC? Slope of BC is nothing but y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Slope between any two points is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So here, slope of BC, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this is nothing but 4 minus 2 by, it is 1 plus 1, it is 2 by 2, and what is slope of BC? It is 1. After getting slope of BC, we find out slope of AD. See, how to find slope of AD? As BC is perpendicular to AD, slope of AD will be reverse a number, change the sign. Now here, reverse a number, you have 1. So whenever you have 1, what is the denominator of 1? It is assumed to be 1. Okay, so now 1 is nothing but 1 by 1. So now, reverse the 1, again we get 1. Change the sign. What is the sign for 1? Plus. This will become minus. When you have to do this, the two lines are perpendicular. Here clearly AD is perpendicular to BC. So that is the reason to find slope of AD, I am doing reverse and change sign. So slope of AD is minus 1. After getting slope of AD, we will find out the equation of AD. Equation of AD with slope. What is slope of AD we have? Minus 1. And on AD, we don't know D, but we know A. So I take A. What is A? A is 5 comma minus 2. So how to find the equation when we have a slope and a point? The equation is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus y1 minus 2 become plus 2 is equal to slope is minus 1 into x minus x1. X1 is 5. Now we'll simplify this. So y plus 2 is equal to minus x minus x minus plus 5. I multiply. Now the order of the writing. First, whatever the terms we have minus x plus 5. Transpose these two terms on the other side. It will become minus 5 minus 2 is equal to 0. So now we get an equation. What is the equation? It is minus x minus y. 5 minus 2 is 3 is equal to 0. Now, the next step, what I do? I take minus sign common. So if I take minus sign common, so what we get is minus terms will become plus, plus terms will become minus. So that is x plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. X plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. This is equation 1. Now, let's slope. The base AC, we got equation of AD. Now, by taking slope as AC, we find out equation of altitude B. So, to find that, what we do? First, we find out slope of AC. Slope of AC is equal to is A and C. See, A and C, these are the 2 points you take. So, slope of AC is Y2 minus y1, y2 minus y1, y1 is minus 2, y2 minus y1 by it is x2 minus x1, 1 minus 5. Okay, slope of AC is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So what we get? We get 4 plus 2, 4 plus 2 is 6 by minus 4, it is minus 3 by 2. 6 by minus 4 can be written as 3s are 2 2s are. So we can write minus 3 numerator. So what is slope of AC? Minus 3 by 2. Now we will find out slope of the line which is perpendicular to AC. So the line which is perpendicular to AC is BE. We will find out slope of BE. So slope of BE is reverse the number, change sign. So what we get? 2 by 3. After getting slope of BE, we will find out the equation of BE with point B, because on BE we know, on BE we know only B. So what is B? We have minus 1 comma 2. And what is the slope we have? The slope of BE is 2 by 3. Slope of BE is 2 by 3. So the equation is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus y1 is equal to m is 2 by 3 into x minus x1. X minus as it is, x1 is minus 1, minus into minus plus 1. Now we cross multiply. So that is 3 into y minus 2 is equal to 2 into x plus 1. Now we'll simplify this. That is 3y minus 4. 3 into y, 3 by 2, those are 4. Is equal to 2x plus 2 multiplied to 2x plus 2. Now we have to write it in order. Order means what? First 2x plus 2 as this. Transpose 3y minus 4 on the other side. It will become minus 3y plus 4 is equal to 0. Now what is the equation? It is 2x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. Okay, 2x minus 3y, 2 plus 4 is 6 is equal to 0. This is equation 2. Now we have AD and BE, both are intersecting lines. So to get the orthocenter, we will solve the equations 1 and 2. Okay, so what is first equation? See, first equation is x plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. And second equation is 2x minus 3 minus 6 is equal to 0. As we are using elimination method, either you have to eliminate x term or y term. Now I am eliminating x term. Suppose if I am eliminating x term, the coefficient of x2 I will multiply to the first equation, and the first equation x coefficient I will multiply to the second equation. Interchange and multiply. So when you observe these two equations, check the x coefficients. It is 1. First equation x coefficient 1 multiply to the second equation. Second equation x coefficient is 2 multiply to the first equation. Okay, so multiply. This is multiplied. This is to be multiplied with 2. So 2x plus 2y minus 6 is equal to 0. And the other one is to be multiplied with 1. So 1 means we get the same equation. 2x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. So now to solve this, what I do is I subtract minus plus minus. I can change the size. Now plus 2x minus 2x you can cancel. Plus 2y plus 3y will become 5y. Minus 12 is equal to 0. Minus 6 is minus 12 is equal to 0. So 5y is equal to 12. So y is 12 by 5. Okay, y value is 12 by 5. Now after getting y value 12 by 5, we need to find the x value. So substitute y is equal to 12 by 5. Either you can substitute in equation 1 or equation 2. I am using equation 1. So what is equation 1? Equation 1 is x plus y minus 3 is equal to 0. So that is x plus y, it is 12 by 5 minus 3 is equal to 0. I substituted the value of y. Now to get the value of x, what I do, I transpose the terms on the other side. So this will become 3 minus 12 by 5. To get the value of x, these two terms you transpose on the other side. Minus 3 will become plus 3, plus 12 by 5 will become minus 12 by 5. So now I take LCM. So x is equal to 50 minus 12 by 5. After taking LCM, we get 50 minus 12 by 5. So what is x is equal to? It is 3 by 5. So now what is ortho center? Ortho center x comma y is nothing but it is 3 by 5 comma 12 by 5. Okay, so this is completed. So the next problem again we solve ortho center. The vertices are minus 5 comma minus 7, 13 comma 2, minus 5 comma 6. So first we draw a triangle. A, B, C are the vertices of a triangle. A, B and B, B. This is A, B and this is B. Okay. So, first we find out slope of B, C. So, before that, this is problem number 3. Let A is equal to minus 5 comma minus 7. B is equal to 13 comma 2. C is equal to minus 5 comma 6. Okay, these are the three vertices. First we find out the slope of BC. Slope of BC. B and C we have today. Slope of BC is y2 minus y1. Subtract y coordinates. 6 minus 2. 6 minus 2. Y. Now subtract x coordinates of BC. Minus 5 minus 13. So, what is slope of BC? It is 4 by minus 18. Okay, minus 5 minus 7 is minus 8. So, if you simplify this, we get minus 2 by 9. 4 are 4, 2 9 is minus 2 by 9. Now, we get the slope of AD, which is perpendicular to BC. Slope of AD is reverse the number, change the sign. This will become 9 by 2. 9 by 2. Now we find out equation of AD. So the equation of AD. While finding equation of AD, on AD we take point A because we don't know D. What is A? Minus 5 comma minus 7. So A is minus 5 comma minus 7. And what is the slope? Slope of AD. Slope of AD is 9 by 2. Now we find out the equation. Find the equation of AD. The formula is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus y1. What is y1? Minus 7. When I substitute this will become plus 7 is equal to m is 9 by 2 into x minus x1 is minus 5. Minus into minus plus. We substitute it. After substituting, we cross multiply, that is 2 into y plus 7 is equal to 9 into x plus 5. Now we simplify this one. So it is 2y plus 14 is equal to 2y plus 14 is equal to 9x plus 45. Now we write it in order. Order means, see, first you write 9x plus 45, transpose those terms, it will become minus 2y minus 14 is equal to 0. So we get 9x minus 2y. 45 minus 14, it is 31 is equal to 0. So 9x minus 2y plus 31 is equal to 0 is an equation. Put it as equation 1. Now after this, what we do is we find out slope of AC. So slope of AC. So what is slope of AC? Okay, it is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So slope of AC, y2 minus y1, y2 minus y1 by it is x2 minus x1. X2 minus of minus x1 minus 5. So it is 13y minus 5 plus 5 is 0. Okay, 6 plus 7 is 13, minus 5 plus 5 is cancel, will get 0. So what is slope of AC? We got 13 by 0. Slope of AC is 13 by 0. So what we do is 13 by 0 actually is not defined. But to find the equation, we need a value. We don't want that not defined value. So slope of AC is 13 by 0. But actually we need slope of B. So what you do, just reverse the number, change sign, you get slope of BE. So slope of BE is reverse the number, change the sign. Okay, so 13 by 0 will become minus 0 by 13. 0 by anything is 0. 0 by anything is 0. That means the slope of BE we got is 0. Now, we find out the equation of BE with point B. What is point B? Point B is 13 comma 2. 13 comma 2. And what is the slope of BE? We have 0. So M is equal to 0. So how to find the equation? This is nothing but y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now we use 13 comma 2 and 0 to find the equation of BE. That is y minus y1. y1 is 2. M value is 0 into x minus x1 is 13. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus 13. Now y minus 2 is equal to c. 0 into anything is 0. Just write 0. Y minus 2 is equal to 0. So clearly, y minus 2 is equal to 0. What is y value? Y value is 2. After getting y value, what we have to do? Substitute y value either in equation 1 or... Okay, we have only one option. We substitute y is equal to 2 in equation 1. We didn't get equation 2, so we are directly equal to value. So substitute y is equal to in equation 1, that is nine x minus 2y plus 31 is equal to 0. So there I am substituting the value of y. 9x minus 2 plus 31 is equal to 0. So that is 9x minus 4 plus 31 is equal to 0. 9x plus 27 is equal to 0. 31 minus 4 is 27. So 9x is equal to minus 27. 9x is equal to minus 27. So what is x now? X is equal to minus 27 by 9. So x value is minus 3. 9 ones are 9 threes are. So x value is minus 3. Now we got the ortho center. What is ortho center? Ortho center x comma y is minus 3 comma 2. Minus 3 comma 2. This is a problem completed. See, now these are very very important problems on ortho center. Please practice these problems. Okay. So next class we will do the problems on ortho center when equation of sides are given. So practice this problem so that the equation of sides will become very easy for you when you solve. Okay, so please practice these problems. Next class will continue. Thank you.